In this tutorial, I'm going to talk to you guys about using arrays in C. A lot of times when we're writing our C programs, we're going to be dealing with a bunch of different data. And one of the things we can do to control and manage and sort of keep track of and organize that data is put data inside of things called arrays. And an array is really useful because it's basically a container where we can store a piece of information. But what happens in your programs when you're dealing with huge amounts of information? Specifically, huge amounts of information that are related, right? Imagine I had a list of like a bunch of names or a list of a bunch of numbers that I needed to keep track of. You know, let's say I had like a list of 100 numbers, right? I wouldn't want to have to create 100 different variables to store all of those different numbers. And this is where arrays come in. An array is essentially a data structure where we can store a bunch of different data values. So inside of an array, unlike a variable where I can only store one value, I can store hundreds or thousands or even millions of values. So inside of a single array, I could store like 5 things or 7 things or 10 numbers or 20 characters. You know, I could store a bunch of different pieces of information, and then all that information would be nice and neat and organized in my program. So I'm going to show you guys how to create arrays. We can create an array a lot like we create a normal variable. And a variable and array are very similar, right? A variable is basically used to define a container that stores a single value. And an array is used to define a container that stores, you know, any number of values. So the first thing we're going to have to do when we create an array is give C some information. And the first piece of information is what type of data we want to store inside of the array. So for example, I could say int, and now I'd be creating an array that would hold integers. If I said char, I'd be creating an array that would hold characters. Or if I said like double, same thing, but for double numbers. So why don't we create an array of integers, and I'm just going to call this lucky numbers. Whenever I create an array, I always want to use a special little symbol. And this symbol will tell C that instead of just creating a normal variable, we want to create an array. And it's an open and closed square brackets. Whenever I use these open and closed square brackets after the name, it's going to tell C like, okay, we want to store multiple pieces of information. Now, there's a bunch of different ways we can create these arrays. The easiest one, though, is to just say equals, and I can make an open and closed curly bracket. And inside of this open and closed curly bracket, I can just start typing out some numbers that I want to put in this array. So we could type out like 4, 8, 15, 16, 23, 42. Now, I could basically type out as many numbers as I wanted, and I could store them inside of this array. So over here, I printed out 6 numbers. I could print out 600 if I wanted. You know, the only thing that's limiting me is how many I can actually put in here. So you'll notice that I put in the piece of data, so like 4, for example, and then I put a comma. And a comma is going to separate all the elements in the array. So we would say 4 is the first element in the array, 8 is the second element in the array. These are all considered to be elements inside of this array. And what's cool about this array is it's now storing all of this information. So unlike a variable where we can only store one value, now in this array I'm storing 6 different numbers. So if I wanted, I can print this out, and I'm actually going to print this out just to show you guys. So remember, we're going to print out a number, and I'm going to show you guys how we can access specific elements inside of this array. So all of these numbers are stored in this lucky numbers array in this array structure, but the question becomes, how do we access them, right? How can I gain access to one of these? Well, I could say %d, so I'm going to print this out, and now I can just say lucky numbers, so I'm going to refer to the name of the array, and when I want to access a specific element, I can make an open and close square bracket, and inside of this open and close square bracket, I want to put the index of the element that I want to access. So all of these elements in here have a specific index, and I can access them by putting the index inside of this square bracket. So if I wanted to access this 4, for example, I can put a 0 inside of here. And now when I run my program, you guys will see that we'll be able to print out that 4. So over here, I'm printing out 4. If I wanted to access this 15, I can put a 2 in here. So now when I run my program, I'll be accessing the 15, as you can see. So one thing you might have noticed by now is that we start the indexes in arrays at 0. So when I wanted to access this 4, instead of putting a 1 in here, I put a 0 in here. right? You might think that 4 would be at index position 1 because it's the first element in the array, but in C, we start array indexes at 0. So actually the first element, this 4, is gonna be at index position 0. So if I was gonna write out indexes, I would say like 4 is at index position 0, this 8 is at index position 1, this 15 is at index position 2, 16 is at index position 3, etc. So that's gonna allow me to access all of these elements inside of the array individually. So I could print them out just by referring to the index inside of these square brackets. Another thing I can do is I can modify some of the elements inside of here. So let's say I want to modify lucky numbers in index position 1. So let's say I want to modify this 8. So I don't like this 8 anymore. So I could basically just assign this a different value like I normally would. So I could say lucky numbers, and I can make an open and close square bracket. We can say 1, and I can just set it equal to something else. So I could set this equal to like 200. Now, when we print out lucky numbers 1, instead of printing out an 8, it's going to be printing out a 200. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to run my program, and you'll see we're printing out 200 instead of 8. So you can modify any of the individual elements inside the array just by referring to the index. And really, when you think about this conceptually, an array is basically just holding a bunch of variables, but those variables don't have names. So when I access lucky numbers 1, it's the same as me accessing an integer variable. It's just that, you know, the array is holding potentially hundreds or thousands or millions of these different variables. So an array is a very useful structure, especially if you're storing data that is very similar. So like I said, I could do this with an int, I could also do this with a double, I could do this with a float, I could do this with whatever I wanted. But there's gonna be situations where you might not necessarily know all the elements that you wanna put inside your array. So let's say I'm creating an array and I don't know what numbers I wanna put in it yet. So maybe I just like wanna create it, I wanna tell C that we need it, but I don't wanna necessarily put anything in it right away. Well, up here, we're basically saying lucky numbers, the open and closed square brackets, and then we're giving it a bunch of information. But if we don't wanna give it all that information, instead, I can just put a semicolon here. But inside of these square brackets, I need to tell C how many elements that this array can hold. So I need to tell C like, hey, this array can only hold like 10 elements, or this array can hold 20 elements or whatever. So let's say we wanted an array that could hold like 10 elements. I can put a 10 right here. And now the capacity of this integer array is 10. So it has the potential to hold 10 items. And what I could do is I could come down here and I could start assigning values to those items. So I could say like lucky numbers 1 is equal to 80, right? So I'm giving lucky numbers 1 a value. And now over here, I could print that value out onto the screen. And you'll see we're printing out 80. But if I tried to print out, for example, lucky numbers 0, so the lucky numbers at index position 0, this is gonna give me a negative 2, which basically means that it's not found. So basically means that there's no element inside of lucky numbers at index position 0. But if I wanted, I could do that. So I could say like lucky numbers 0 is equal to 90. And now when I run my program, it's gonna be able to do that. So it'll be able to get that value. So in a lot of situations, you're just gonna wanna give these arrays values upfront right off the bat. But in a lot of other situations, you're not gonna necessarily know what's supposed to go in there. But in a situation like that, you still have to tell C how many elements the array is gonna hold. You still have to like rigorously define like, hey, this array can only hold 10 elements. And that's just so C is able to allocate enough memory in order to hold all of those elements. So that's kind of the basics of working with arrays. Now I do wanna point out one thing that we've been using in this course has been strings. So I've been creating character strings. So I could say like char phrase, and I could set this equal to Giraffe Academy. Or other times in the program, we created like, when we were making our little game, we created an arrays and I would just say like 20, and then I would get input from the user and put that information in here. This is basically a string of characters. So anytime we create a string in C, like if I was to create a string over here, I called it like array or whatever, this is an array. So we've kind of just been taking this for granted. Like I've kind of just been calling this a string or calling it like a string of characters, but it's basically just an array of characters. The only difference is this is such a common thing to use in our programs that C makes it special and makes it really easy for us to create it. But just like that array of integers, this is also an array. So now you kind of have a better understanding of what strings are and what they're actually doing.